One day in the year 2007, we had a break in school, so I decided to spend some time in my brother's home. Because I had not much to do, so one Wednesday after my brother had gone to work, I was keeping myself busy with the TV. There was this television program called New Dawn with Funmi Iyanda in my country, Nigeria. And on this very day, a man was invited to speak about entrepreneurship. Before this time, entrepreneurship had been the subject I loved, and I have even gotten involved with different businesses. Still, I couldn't remember ever making a do-or-die decision for entrepreneurship until this Wednesday. As this man talked about entrepreneurship, something struck my brain. I stood up and told myself, I'd rather build a company of my own or die. The very day I made this commitment, I didn't even have $100 to my name, nor did I have anyone in my family who could give me $1,000 for business. Yet, I made the decision to build a company no matter what. Decisions build the world. When I was a little boy, my father told me the story of how he stopped smoking. The story went like this. He and his smoker friends were living in the village, and one fateful day they were hungry for a cigarette and couldn't find any in their village. Hence, they had to walk several kilometers to another village to buy a cigarette. Rain fell as they were on the road looking for a cigarette, and when they returned, my father looked at the cigar they had wasted all their lives searching for and broke his own. Then he told himself, I'll never smoke again in my life. That was the last day my father had anything to do with a cigarette. Today, he's an octogenarian, in good shape for his age. If he had not stopped smoking, nobody knows if he would still be alive. But it's all about decisions. The single habit that can change your life and your world is the habit of making a real decision about what you want and what you don't. I call it real decision because there are fake decisions that people make every day. Fake decisions come when people are not truly tired of their situations, though they seem to be making decisions for change, but deep within them, they are not tired of their old life. People may tell you that they want to lose weight, but they still cherish junk food. People may say to you that they want to have a great marriage, but they still enjoy running around people in the opposite sex for the wrong reason. People may tell you that they want to be rich, but they have never gotten to a point when they want to be rich or die. So whatever decision they make is fake. Yes, I do believe in do or die. In the real sense of what decisions mean, it means I'll do it or die. It's like writing on raw cement, it sticks forever. There's no going back, even in the face of death. Even though do or die has been associated with negative things over the years, it actually is the spirit of every great achievement. You can't achieve any significant success in life if you don't get to a point where you burn your bridge. Most people never burn their bridges. Most people never make up their minds to fight with their last blood. Most people never put their lives on the line, and that's why most people never achieve greatness. Let's think about poverty for a second. If you are born poor by a poor parent, I have bad news for you, and that is, your chances of ever having enough money are so lean that only 4 out of 100 people born in poverty will ever have more money than their parents. Poverty begets poverty. In my country, they will call it a generational curse. No, it's not a generational curse. It only requires that you'll have to burn your bridge if you will ever break through the poverty line. When I mention do or die, I don't mean you should do illegal or sinful things. I mean you must be willing to do anything within the ambit of the law of men and God. I mean you must be willing to sacrifice everything. It could be the TV, social media, pleasure, some sleep. I mean, you must be curious and relentless. When I made the decision to destroy poverty, I started reading any book that came my way about money and entrepreneurship. I started learning from anyone I know that had done what I wanted to do. The universe makes way for the stubborn ones. Ralph Waldo Emerson once said, "Once you make a decision, the universe conspires to make it happen. Life is a difficult place and is mostly unfair. If you decided to achieve something worthwhile with your life, let me tell you what will happen to you. You will be frustrated. Life will make living unbearable for you. you will be rejected by people and blocked by angels of achievement. This happens not because the universe hates you, but because it does not want to give its crown to those who don't deserve it. For the people who have burnt their bridges and have made a decision never to look back, a time will come when the whole universe will bow to make way for you. Ask any successful entrepreneur who has built a company from scratch, and they will tell you, when you start, it seems as if everything you touch becomes junk. Everything you attempt simply fails. Everything you do simply ends in disaster. However, a time comes, usually after your face had been crushed and your spirit burnt without you giving up, then a sudden light appears and you are given this magic wand. Now, everything you touch suddenly becomes money. Now you've paid your dues and the universe has counted you worthy of the glorious crown. Self-esteem and decision-making. In my studies and life's experiences, I've seen that most people are not able to burn their bridges because they have low self-esteem. So I think here is the right place to start your journey. Improve your self-esteem and you'll be able to make real decisions that will change your life. Our self-esteem is directly correlated with our self-talk. We all speak to ourselves every day. Our internal dialogues may be secret to other people, but they will influence what we believe is possible for our lives. What even makes this worse is that we repeat this dialogue every day. According to what I read, an average human processes between 60,000 to 80,000 thoughts every day, and more than 80% of that is simply the repetition of what he thought yesterday. Hence, people who have negative internal dialogues repeat those dialogues thousands of times to themselves every month or year. Several studies have found that even the biggest lies can become a gospel if only it gets repeated long enough. What this means is that if your inner dialogues are negative, you have worked very hard to convince yourself that you're not good enough and you will believe this. So, how can people change their inner dialogues and self-esteem so they can achieve greatness? What helps me is reading stories of ordinary people in history who achieved great things. I think such stories can help you too. So, you must read good books. A summary of this video is this. The one thing that changes people's lives is the decisions they make, the bridges they burn, and the do-or-die commitments they make. If you want to change your life and world, you have to make real decisions. You have to burn your bridges, and you have to make a do-or-die commitment. Thanks for watching. We love you.